لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Some family has one of them brother or sister has depression or anxiety. And some sisters called me in Islamic way, you have any cure, you have any medicine. And actually Ibn Qayyim mentioned like seven way you can cure all of us from depression or anxiety. And I try inshallah every week say something from Islamic way. Number one, don't think too much about your problem. Because shaitan wanna take your brain away. Don't focus in prayer. And you wanna sit down as dumb people. Sit down, don't think, and your brain gone. Number two is very, very important. He said, لابد من قراءة القرآن بالتدبر والتمعن. He said, you must read Quran with understanding. Why? يعني imagine one day Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام has some money and he spent it to poor Muslims. And one guy came to him very harsh with Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام saying, اعدل. Must be just Muhammad. And Prophet Muhammad looked at him and Ismail said, what are you doing? I spent the money to poor. ويلك من يعدل إذا لم أعدل. Who can be just? It can be just. If not me. And Ismail said, رحم الله أخي موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام. Look, when Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام reads some ayat, he understanding and making practice in his dunya. He said, oh, my brother موسى عليه السلام, Prophet موسى, his people annoying him more than me. And he be patient. And you must learn. When you recite some ayat about Prophet موسى عليه السلام, say عليه السلام. Always have be patient. With Fir'aun has be patient. With his people has been patient, okay? And they make da'wah, say, إله إله إلا الله, لا إله إلا الله. When you mention Prophet Musa عليه السلام, because some sister up now, imagine the wife of Fir'aun. Wife of Fir'aun's queen has money, gold, can sell everything. A lot of people serving to her. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to her, لا إله إلا الله, she rejected everything. She believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She followed Prophet Musa and she said, رَبِّ نَجِّنِي مِن فِرْعَوْنَ وَعَمَلِي وَنَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. Imagine if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us real iman. Don't think too much about dunya. Don't think too much about your home, your car, no. I say that the wife of Fir'aun, she rejected everything. And she think about what? Paradise. No stress, no depression. When you read Quran, imagine Prophet Ayyub alayhi salam. Where's brother Ayyub? Pakistan Ayyub, Karachi. Prophet Ayyub alayhi salam, imagine, has 12 kids. 12. And he was very rich man, multimillionaire. And healthy, wealthy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take him child, one after another. Everyone die. And he saw that. After a while, he be poor. After a while, he's very sick. And Allah gave him be patient. Why Allah mentioned Prophet Ayyub to us? To be patient. Any calamity come to you, be patient. But mention Allah. Prophet Ayyub alayhi salam always mention Allah. No depression, no anxiety. If you read any medicine here to give to people about depression and anxiety, at least side effect. To commit suicide. May Allah protect us. And we have Quran. And Allah said in Surah Isra, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. It's cure and mercy to who? Good believers. And they must use Quran as what? As cure, as a guidance, as a light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So next week, shall we continue? This is number 3, shall we? هذا صلى الله عليه وسلم.